Good morning all. In first BSc, I am first sem. So you have the paper. First, the title of the paper, that is Diversity and Functional Anatomy of Non-Chordates. In this semester, you are studying with all the details about non-chordates. So the science of classifying organisms is called taxonomy. Every species discovered so far, they are classified into five kingdoms. One among them is Kingdom Animalia or Animal Kingdom. The members of Kingdom Animalia are further classified into different phyla, class, order, family and genus based on certain characteristic features. So one of the most fundamental form of classification of animals is the presence or the absence of notochord. Hence, there are two important major groups. They are present. First one, it is chordates, and second one, they are non-chordates. So non-chordates, those are the animals without a notochord. So this phylum consisting of animal-like, worm-like, marine species with organ system level of organization. So members of the phylum Protozoa, Porifera, Cylindrata, Platyhelminthes, Ascalminthes, Annelida, Orthopoda, Mollusca and Echinodermata all falls under this non-chordata. So coming to my part of syllabus, that is the first phylum what I am discussing, that is phylum Platyhelminthes. So here you can call them as flatworms. When you split Platyhelminthes into two different words, for example, like platy means flat and helminthes means worms. So totally you can call them as flat worms. So the term Platyhelminthes was first proposed by Gagan Bohr in 1859. So he considered it as the most primitive of all the helminthes. So there are about 18,500 species which comes under the phylum Platyhelminthes, and majority of them are parasitic. Only 20 species are free living species. So members of this phylum Planaria, for example, you know about it, Planaria, tapeworm and liverfluke. So the branch of biology which deals with the study of helminthes is known as helminthology. So first we'll look at the general characteristics of phylum Platyhelminthes. So by knowing or studying the general characteristic, you can able to identify a species and you can categorized into a different phylum. So first general character, that is they are soft-bodied and unsegmented worms. They show bilateral symmetry and they are dorsoventrally flat worms. So bilateral symmetry, so the anatomical part, they are arranged on opposite side of a median axis, and that we call it as bilateral symmetry. So they are triploblastic, having three germinal layers, that is outer ectoderm, middle mesoderm and the inner endoderm. So the epidermis, it is soft and you can see syncytial. That means the epidermis contains the cells with many nuclei. It is formed by the result of fusion of many cells. So this is a one of a characteristic feature of a parasite. Okay. The epidermis is ciliated in case of Turbellaria. So in case of trematoda and cestoda, the epidermis, it is covered by cuticle. See, tarbal area, trematoda and cestoda, they belong, they are the different classes of phylum Platyhelminthes. See here, the tarbal area class, it is the examples which belongs to the tarbal area, they are free living forms, whereas trematoda and cestoda, they are the parasitic worms. So this parasitic worms, they are covered with the cuticle, whereas the free living forms, they are covered with the cilia. So exo and endoskeleton is completely absent. So almost the majority of them, or the majority of the species of phylum Platyhelminthes, they are parasites. So the parasites, they have some adaptations. They shows suckers, hooks, or both for the attachment to the host body. So these are the first animal to develop the organ system. So next one that you may know about, the coelom, that is a true body cavity. It is absent in case of phylum Platyhelminthes. Here the space between the body organs, it is filled with a loose parenchyma. So the alimentary canal is absent or highly branched, and anus is absent. So digestion, what we call it as, that is, it is incomplete. That means digestive system is incomplete, where it should starts with mouth and it should ends with the anus. Here there is we call it as incomplete digestive system. Circulatory and respiratory systems are absent. Muscular system, it is well developed. It is mesenchymal in origin. The system consisting of circular, longitudinal and oblique muscles, which is present beneath the epidermis. Excretory system consisting of flame bulbs or flame cells or photonephridia, which are connected to the excretory ducts. Nervous system and sense organs, they are poorly developed. Usually hermaphrodite animals. That means this is the condition of having both male and the female reproductive organ in a single individual. Fertilization in case of Platyhelminthes, it is internal, and the development may be direct or indirect. So it includes free living forms, ectoparasite, that means which lives outside the body of the host, and the endoparasite, that means which lives inside the body of the host. So these are the some of the general characters of the phylum Platyhelminthes. So this phylum Platyhelminthes have been divided or classified into three major classes. First one, class Turbellaria, class Trematoda and class Cestoda. Class Turbellaria, these are free living organism. Mostly they are found in fresh water. The body is dorsoventrally flattened. Hooks and suckers are not present in case of Turbellaria. Very good example, that is Planaria. Class Trematoda, these are mostly parasitic. Hooks and suckers usually present. Example, Fasciola hepatica, which is commonly called as liver fluke. Class Cestoda, these are exclusively parasitic. They have hooks and suckers. Example, Thania species like Thania solium or Thania saginata, commonly called it as tapeworms. So these are the three important classes of phylum Platyhelminthes. So the next part, what you are studying in the phylum Platyhelminthes, that is the type study. So for the type study in the phylum Platyhelminthes, you have Thania solium, which is commonly called it as tapeworm. So when you look at its classification, it belongs to the phylum Platyhelminthes, class Taxoda, order Theniioidea, genus Thenia, and the species Solium. So here Thenia solium, it is commonly called as pork tapeworm of man. As the adult lives in the intestine of the man, leading an endoparasitic life. That means its life history is completed in two hosts, that is what we call it as digenetic. Di means two and two host. So man being the primary host and pig being the secondary host, or you can call it as intermediate host. So except the adult, the various stages of its life history are passed in the body of the secondary host. So the Thenia solium, the body of tapeworm, it has been divided into scolex or head, neck, and the body segments or the strobila. So Thenia solium, it is a long dorsoventrally flattened narrow ribbon like reaching a length of 2 to 3 meters. The color of the body is opaque white. So the first part of the body, that is the scolex or the head. So the anterior end of the body of the Thenia, which looks like a knob, that is what we call it as the scolex. So in this picture, you can see the presence of the scolex, which is a knob-like. The scolex, it is smaller than a head of a pin, about 1 mm in diameter, with 4 cup-like muscular sulcus having radial muscles, and an anterior round prominent rostellum having 22 to 32 curved chitinous hook, which are arranged in a circular manner. So here you can see the enlarged portion, the second picture, which shows the enlarged picture of rostellum, which in the middle, and it is surrounded by number of hooks, small hooks, and along with that there is a presence of 4 suckers. So this is the structure of the scolex of Thenia solium. So next to the scolex, what you find, it is the neck. Behind the scolex is a thin, small, narrow, unsegmented neck which grows continuously and proliferates proglottids by transverse fission or asexual budding. So the last part of the body, that is the strobila or body segment. The neck, it is followed by a flattened ribbon like body called strobila. The strobila forms the main bulk of the body and consisting of series of proglottids, which are arranged in a linear fashion. So this proglottids will be of 3 different type, like immature proglottid. First, behind the neck, next to the neck, what you find, it is the immature proglottids. Next, it is the mature proglottids. The last part of the body, what we call body segments, that what we call it as the gravid proglottids. So the next part in the discussion, that is reproductive part or reproduction. So all tapeworms are hermaphrodite. That means they contain both the male and the female reproductive organs. So each mature proglottids, they comprised of complete set of male and female reproductive organs. So for the detailed study of reproduction, so you can see the male reproductive organs and female reproductive organ. Male reproductive organ consisting of testis, vas efferentia, vas deferens, serous or penis, and a serous sac. Female reproductive organ consisting of bilobed ovary, oviduct, O-type, vagina, uterus, Mylage gland and Vitelline gland. So in this picture, you can clearly see a single proglottids which show the reproductive organ, that is both male reproductive organ and the female reproductive organ in a mature proglottids. So first we'll look into the male reproductive organ. So first very important organ of reproduction, that is testis. So the testis, you can see in the picture, is small spherical bodies which are scattered throughout the mesenchyma. That what we call it as the testis. Next, vas efferentia. From each testis, a fine ductule, that what we call it as the vas efferentia, arises. So this vas efferentia usually gets interconnected with the similar ductules from the surrounding of the testis. So vas deferens, it is a thick and convoluted tubule extending up to the lateral margin of the proglottid at the right angles to it. The next one, that is the serous. So the serous, it is the muscular copulatory organ, that what we call it as the serous. Next one, that is the genital atrium. The serous, they open into a cup-shaped genital atrium through male genital pore. The genital atrium, in turn, it opens into outside through gonopore. So the common gonopores, they are arranged alternatively on both sides of the proglottids. So next, it is the female reproductive organ, and this is the details of the arrangement of the female reproductive organ. The main organ of reproduction, that is the ovary, which is bilobed organ, both the lobes, they are connected with that of the ovarian bridge. Next, oviduct. So it arises from the ovarian bridge and opens into the oocyte. So it is a spherical bulb which is situated at the junction, and the seminal vesicle stores the sperms temporarily. Mylage gland. So this is a gland which lubricates the egg in the uterus. Vagina, which swells to form the sperm storing sac. Uterus. So this becomes large and highly branched with the eggs in various developmental stages. And vitelline gland, consisting of numerous follicle secreting yolk cells. So next it is the fertilization. So cell fertilization takes place in thania. The serous or the penis of the segment is inserted into the vagina of the same segment. The sperms received are stored in the seminal receptacle. The egg gets fertilized in the oviduct and enters into the uterus, and the eggs, they are collected in the uterus. The eggs, they are very small in size, measuring about 40 microns in diameter. The egg contain large amount of yolk and they are surrounded by egg capsule. Thank you.